Hey, hi, welcome guys. Welcome back to our channel, which is Pybron. As we had discussed in my last session, linear regression model, and we build our linear regression model, and also we try to deploy in one of the cloud platform, which is Heroku. Now today, again, I got some kind of requirement regarding for the EDA techniques and hypothesis testing, how we are going to incorporate the hypothesis testing in the real time to analyze the data and to penalize the model, right? So in today's session, basically, we are going to discuss about the basic EDA techniques, simple linear regression. Okay, so what the things we are going to cover in today's session, I set some agenda for today's session. So we will see simple linear regression, basic EDA techniques, p-value, how the p-value will help, to identify the features we should incorporate to the model building, which feature we should drop to the model building. And also we will see hypothesis testing, how the hypothesis testing is going to incorporate whenever you are going to build a model. And later on we will see how the model evaluation, we are going to evaluate the model. At the end, we have to evaluate the model using the R squared value. And also we will see some of the drawback of the R squared value, right? Hope you understood. Hope I'm clear with the agendas for this session. Now, without getting delay, let me share my Jupyter notebook. So we all are in the same set. So yes, let me go to the Jupyter notebook. Okay, guys. So in this Jupyter notebook, if you can see my Jupyter notebook. Okay. So basically in this Jupyter notebook, I just load some data set. I just loaded my data set using sklearn. So in case of sklearn, there is an inbuilt data set is there, that is Boston data set. Okay, so basically this is the data set, Boston data set. I am going to load my data set. You can take CSV file if you have the data set. If you are going to collect the data from the Kaggle or some GitHub, then that is also fine, no worries at all, it will work fine. Okay, so as in case of sklearn, there is a preloaded data set is available, so I took that data set, right? So I load my data set. Okay, so I create a data frame here. So up to this, no doubt we had seen in our pandas session, so we created our data set, right? So we created our data set, no doubt, right? So next, what we can do, okay. So next, what we can do, let me go down. So once your data set has been created, next, this is the independent feature. If you will go to this data set, these are my independent features, CRIM, ZN. Okay, basically what the problem we have, just let me clear with the problem. So I loaded my independent feature and I'm going to load my dependent feature also. So this is my dependent feature target. So boston.target I'm loading, and I'm giving that column name is the price. And I create one data frame with the name of the target. And at the end, what I'm going to do, I'm going to concatenate these two data frames. One data frame name is boss, another data frame name is target. I'm going to concatenate these two data frame, boss and target, axis is equal to 1 and join is equal to inner. Okay, so how it is going to work? If you are not able to understand, go with my pandas session. I created a separate video how the concatenation is working. As axis 1 is 1 in the sense of what is saying, it is column wise. It is going to concatenate your data frame in the column wise, right? Okay, so I created my main data frame here. So up to this, no doubt. So here you can see, here these are the independent feature, CRIM, ZN, index, this up to this is my independent feature and this is my dependent feature. So basically now I'm going to elaborate the problem, what the problem we are going to deal with, guys. So basically we have to predict the home price. We are going to predict the home price. Okay, so based on this input feature, based on this many input feature, we are going to predict what should be the price of my Boston Lane home, right? Hope you clear with the agenda. Now, if you can see, if I'm loading the data set here, there total how many rows are there? 506 rows we have and 14 columns is there, including target column, right? Now, once you loaded a data frame, your first job will be, you have to check, is there any null value present in the data frame or not? First, as a data scientist, your first job will be, you have to check whether is any missing values present or not. So how we are going to check? Main data frame dot is null dot sum. So I'm going to check, is there any null value present or not? So I can see there is no null value at all. In any of the column, there is no null value. Each and every column having zero means there is no null value at all. Okay. So once it is done, Next, what is your task? Your task is to check the data type. Okay, because machine will understand only numeric thing. It will not understand any kind of word, A, B, C, D, alphabet. It will not understand at all. So you have to check what is the data type of my columns. So how you can check? Just call the data frame and call the D types argument. So it will give you the type of the data. So in this data frame, it's pretty much simple data frame. You can see all the data is in the form of float. So no need to do any kind of encoding. No need to apply any kind of encoding techniques here, guys. No need to apply any kind of encoding techniques because everything is in the float. If it will be object or some kind of string value will be present, then we have to apply some kind of, level encoding technique. But here, in this data frame, you should not need to apply any kind of level encoding technique or encoding techniques, right? Now, next, I'm going to check my shape. What is my shape of the data frame? So you can see my data frame shape is 506,14, right? Okay, up to this, no doubt. Okay, now also if you want to check any null value, so there is a one method which is known as the info method. You can call the info method, it will give very good result. So you can see we have how many rows we have? We have 506, and here also saying 506 not null. Non-null means there is 506 is non-null value, means there everything is filled, means there is no null value. And also you can see there is a data type also. There is a different method, different kind of techniques is there with which you can check the D type as well as null value. So info method is kind of, you can say info method is kind of a method will give you all those things in a one shot. Means basically shape, if you are calling the shape method, then it will give the shape of the data frame. And if you want to check the D type, then you have to call the D type method. But if you are calling the info method, all those two things you are getting in a single frame, right, guys? So that's a benefit of the info method, nothing else. Now, up to this, no doubt at all. Now, as a data scientist, your job is how these features is going to affect my target column, guys. So here is my feature CRIM, ZN. These are my features, right? These are my features. So these all feature, how it is going to affect to my price. I want to see whether it's a positive correlation, it's a negative correlation, or there is no relationship. That also I want to see, right? So in order to check that, as all this data type is in the float, right? So there is a no categorical kind of data. So we can plot a scatter plot and we can see whether CRIM has been positive relationship with the price or negative relationship, or there is no relationship. That also we can see. So how we can see basically? Okay, how we can see, just go down. Okay, so what I did in Pandas itself, there is a one method. If you have watched my visualization playlist, just go to my visualization playlist. These things I explain very clearly, guys. These things I explain very clearly, and how the plot method is going to use. Here we have to pass two things. Let me clear this diagram first. Okay, so here we have to pass two things. One is kind. What is the which kind of plot you are going to plot? Which kind of graph you are going to plot? So here I kept scatter. Why scatter? Because all this data is in the form of the float. So in case of float, you should use scatter plot only. Okay. And then X, what is my independent variable here? I'm going to check each column one by one with the price. So how the CRIM is going to affect to my price, how the ZN is going to affect to my price, how the index column is going to affect my price. Each and every column I want to see how it is going to affect to my price column, right? How it is going to affect my target column, right? Okay, so what I'm going to do, just try to understand, this is your kind, which kind of plot you are going to plot, whether it's a bar plot, whether it's a scatter plot, or which kind of plot you are going to do. Okay, so here you have to mention that plot type, and here in X you have to pass independent column name. So what is my column name? CRIM. And then price, I'm going to pass my price, because it's means CRIM, how the CRIM is going to affect to price, that I want to see, right? And X is equal to 0 in the sense of where I want to print this. So here in the zeroth index, we have to print, right? So that's what x is equal to zero. Figure size, what is figure size basically? Figure size is nothing but what should be the size of this figure. So 16 cross 8 I have kept, right? So here, what is that? So here, this is my 16, y is the, so this is my x 16 and y is 8. So right, so kind of thing I'm going to keep here. Similarly, I'm going to check scatter plot between the, Jordan and price. Similarly, you can check with the scatter with the index. So just now I try to check for the three independent column, CRIM, Z and index. So how it is going to affect to my price column, guys. So you can see, if you can watch carefully, if you can see this diagram, so you can see here pretty much it's defined CRIM. How CRIM is going to affect, you can see having the negative relationship. If you will try to draw one straight line, you can see if I'm going to increase my CRIM, my price is going to decrease. You can see, so I can say CRIM having the negative relationship. You can see, also you can see the slope. You can see if you will try to draw an angle, you can see this angle is greater than 90 degree, right? This angle is greater than 90 degree, and tan 90, if any angle which is tan angle, you can say tan theta greater than 90 degree is always be negative. It will give always less than zero value. Okay, so you can see it's a negative relationship, right? So with the graph I can see it's a negative relationship. Also I will prove you guys with the help of the coefficient how whether it's a negative relationship or not. Okay, similarly you can see in the Jordan column how it is Jordan column is going to affect to my price column, right? So you can see I cannot say any relationship right now, right? There is no proper relationship. Okay, so I can whether it means I can ignore this Jordan column or just incorporate as enough. In the first go, whenever you are going to build a model, don't drop any column. First thing keep in your mind, whenever you are going to build any kind of model, first incorporate with all features. Okay, later on if your model accuracy or model evaluation result will not give the proper result, then you should think about this. But as of now I can see Jordan is not going to affect to my target column. Similarly, if you can see the index, so index I can see there is some kind of negative relationship. If I'll try to draw a straight line, I can see the index having the negative relationship, guys. You see my index, if I'm going to increase, so I can see price is going to decrease, right? So it's having some negative relationship, no doubt at all. It's having some negative relationship. Okay, so right now I did analysis for only, three column. So what about the others, right? You can check the others also. See, I checked this, what I'm going to do, I'm going to segregate my data frame into two part. One is independent part, another is dependent part. So what is my dependent part? Price is my dependent part. So I create a Y variable with price. Okay. And similarly, I'm going to drop price. So if I'll drop, then what will be left? Only dependent variable, independent variable. So independent variable, I am going to keep inside of my X, right? And this is this piece of code. I'll upload this code in a GitHub, guys. Don't worry about that. You will get a GitHub link in the video description. Okay. You just copy and paste in your data set. Okay. So here, what I'm going to do, just try to understand. I'm going to keep my figure size 20, 30 and background is white. So, and next what I'm going to do, I am going to check my column, because inside of X, I kept. Drop the price after dropping the whatever remaining that I kept inside of X, right? So column in X, plot number less than equal to 15, means up to 15 it can draw, up to 15 it can draw. Okay, now plot dot subplot, I'm going to plot each column how it is going to affect to my target column, right? So that I'm going to see one by one and I'm going to plot it here. And you can see how it is going to affect here. Same thing CRIM is going to show here. Similarly, Jordan also, Indus also, and you can see CHAS is not, there is, there is only one kind of data, means, it's a kind of There is no relationship, but you can say it might be some relationship. Okay. Similarly, NOx having the negative relationship, RM having the positive relationship. See, RM going to increase, then price is going to increase. So RM having the positive. As of now, we are visualizing our data. As of now, we are trying to visualize our data and we are trying to build our, you know, assumption how the column is going to affect to the model. But later on in this session, just try to watch this complete video. You will get a good idea about this. You will get a very good, very pretty much good idea about the, you know, kind of this. Okay. Similarly, you can see DIS, how it is going to affect, okay, everything. See, LSTAT, it is having the negative relationship. Okay. So once it is done, next is what? I can see all the visual. I represent all the data set in the visualized format, right, guys? Now, next is what? I'm going to build a simple linear regression. What do you mean by this linear regression? Linear regression, in the last session, in my previous linear regression video, I explained very clearly what is linear regression and when we should apply the regression kind of algorithm. Here, simple linear regression is what is nothing but if you know the state line equation of a state line, what is the equation of a state line? Y is equal to mx plus c. So here, this dependent variable is depending only one feature, that is x, right? So then it is known as the simple linear regression. But then what is the multiple linear regression, guys? So y is equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3. If the case is like this, then I can say it's a multiple linear regression, because this y is going to depend on these three, on the multiple independent factor, I can say. So this is known as the multiple linear regression. This is known as the simple linear regression. So first, I am trying to build my model based on the simple linear regression, right? Okay. So I guess this video will become very large. So what I'm trying to do, I'm going to stop my video here, and simple linear regression, I'll try to build in the separate video, in the next video, guys. So keep on watching, okay?